Well, good morning, everyone. Good morning, good morning. Welcome to Oakham Baptist Church Day. It's great that we can be together. I'm Tom, I'm the pastor here. And we're gathering here in the building this morning, but we've also got walking church that are gathering this morning as well. So every third Sunday of the month, if you come at 10:15, walking church go off and they do church together in a walking format. The name's quite simple, gives it away, doesn't it really? Walking church, it's church whilst you're walking, and it's quite good. If you've never done that before, then that's every third Sunday. So I don't know, they've probably gone by now, you've missed them. So that's going to be on September the 15th is the next one. If you want to come and give that a go, September the 15th is the next walking church. So do come along to that. Normally we get straight into a bit of praise, but I'm just going to hand over to Suzanne, who's just going to share a little bit of something with us.
Thank you very much. Morning, everybody. Lovely to see all your smiling faces. I woke up in the middle of the night last Saturday with a picture and a word, and I really felt strongly it was for the church, so I shared it with the deacons and they agreed. There's a scripture in Song of Songs, and some of you will remember the 1990s Kevin Prosh chorus that says, "He brought me to his banqueting table, and his banner over me is love." And I had this picture of a banqueting table, piles of food, everything you could wish for. And I felt like God was saying, for us, he has provided everything that we need. That's balanced with another scripture in 2 Peter that says, his divine power has given us everything we need for life and godliness. And so this banqueting table isn't just delicious food. It's not for our physical need, although there is healing in the house of God. But that's not what this was about. This is about what you need to fulfill the purpose of God in your life. And I felt a real, and I'm feeling it now, a real strong challenge. Some of you have felt the call of God for something, and you feel you've not got what you need, and you feel that you can't do it, you're not good enough, you're not confident enough, you've not got the gifts. The gift of God is provided for the calling he's put on your life. Lots of us know the scripture, Jeremiah 29:11. I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. And there's hope in the house of God this morning. Some of you in this room are called to ministry. Some of you are called to mission. Some of you are called to be life group leaders or leaders of children's work or youth work. Whatever the ministry, lots of you, I feel, God's saying, are not confident to step into ministry. Prayer response team, praying for your friends and neighbours, praying in your life group, speaking out in your life group. And I just want to say, the table is laid, you're invited to the banquet, there is everything you need. God wants you this morning in this house to receive what you need from him. The other thing, and I think this might be holding some people back, I saw the banquet like when we do a bring and share lunch, right? And everybody brings too much food, okay? But there might be a plate of 15 sausage rolls. And you might think, oh, quite fancy a sausage roll, but other people might. And you leave the sausage roll because you think someone else might want it. I just want to say the gift of God is not like that. The gift of God is here. If he has purposed for you to prophesy, for you to have a word of wisdom or a word of knowledge, there's enough food. The plates of God are bigger than you can imagine. There's enough gifting in the hand of God. So you're invited to the banqueting table, and this morning he wants you to receive from him. So as we worship, I want to really encourage you. If you'd like prayer at the end and someone to agree with you in prayer, prayer ministry team will be here. I will be here. You can grab Tom or any of the deacons. We will pray with you to receive. But I just want to encourage you this morning to open your heart to receive what you need from him, because he's already provided it. It's laid out on the table and he's invited you to come. His banner over you is love. He loves you. He has a purpose for you. He has a plan for you. And he wants you to step into it. He wants to anoint you for that. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you for your faithfulness and for your abundant provision. I thank you that in your house this morning, there's an abundance of anointing, of gifting, of all that you have called us to be, for, to fulfill your purposes in our lives. You have created us, each and every one of us. You have made us how we are for a reason, for a purpose. And I want to thank you that you have provided all that we need to live that out. And so right at the start, Lord, we say sorry for not believing and trusting you enough to step out into those giftings. And we open our hearts to receive from you. I pray, Holy Spirit, you'll come on your people powerfully this morning, that you release us into a new level of gifting, of anointing, that you would bring out those abilities you've put deep inside each one of us. You would help us to walk in faith with you, to trust you, to not be scared of speaking out when we feel you've spoken to us. I pray for that boldness of the Holy Ghost that we read about in Acts, that the Holy Spirit came on them and they spoke the word of God boldly. I ask you for that boldness this morning, Lord. I ask you for a releasing of your gifts and that we would learn how to receive from you and to walk with you for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
So we're going to invite you to come and praise God. The Bible teaches us that God created everything and everyone, including you. He doesn't make mistakes. He decided you're worth it. It's worth it. And he created everything for his glory, for his pleasure. And you're one of those people. Isn't that fantastic? So let's invite everything to praise God together.
Okay, so let's have everyone standing up, however you feel comfortable. One of the lyrics in this song is, as long as I'm breathing, I have a reason to praise the Lord. So just feel released in that and comfortable in that. All right, so we're going to sing, Let Everything That Has Breath Praise the Lord. Let everything.
Let everything.
That has breath.
That has breath.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let everything.
Let everything.
That has breath.
That has breath.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I'll praise in the valley. Praise on the mountain. I'll praise when I'm sure. Praise when I'm doubting. I'll praise when I'm numbered. Praise when surrounded. Cause praise is the waters my enemies drowning.
I'll
praise in the valley. Praise on the mountain. I'll praise when I'm sure, praise when I'm doubting. I'll praise when I'm numbered, praise when surrounded. Cause praise is the waters my enemies drowning. As long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. I'll praise when I feel it. I'll praise when I don't. I'll praise cause I know you're still in control. My praise is a weapon. It's more than a sound. My praise is a shout that brings Jericho down. As long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord,
oh my soul.
I won't be quiet.
I won't be quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it inside? I won't be quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it inside? Praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul.
I'll praise 'cause you're sovereign.
I'll praise 'cause you're sovereign. Praise 'cause you reign. Praise 'cause you rose and defeated the grave. Oh, praise 'cause you're faithful. Praise 'cause you're true. Praise 'cause there's nobody greater than you. Oh, praise 'cause you're sovereign. Praise 'cause you reign. Praise 'cause you rose and defeated the grave. Oh, praise 'cause you're faithful. Praise 'cause you're true. Praise 'cause there's nobody greater than you. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul.
I won't be quiet.
I won't be quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it inside? I won't be quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it inside? I won't be quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it inside? Praise the Lord, oh my soul.
Everything that has breath. Let everything.
Let everything.
That has breath.
That has breath.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And just let out some praise. Woo!
Thank you, Jesus. You're worthy.
You know, God's divine purpose was that everyone and everything would bring him praise. But we stuffed it up. Well, at least I stuffed it up. I know that I fall short of God's glory. But you know what? God knew it and planned for it and sent Jesus to rescue me. Did he rescue you? From yourself, from your sinfulness? He sent the light of the world into the darkness, so that we could come back and praise his name. Isn't he a great God? Yes. So let's talk about this light of the world.
Together worthy. to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
I'll never know.
I'll never know how much it costs to see my sin upon that cross. No, I'll never know how much it costs to see my sin upon that cross.
Here I
am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
Lord, you are wonderful to us, even though we've let you down. And we've fallen short. We confess with our mouths that Jesus is needed here to raise us up, to glimpse heaven, to bask in his glory, to accept his rescue on a cross. So we confess our sins, we confess our need of Jesus, and we thank you that we can glory in your presence and in your forgiveness because of what he has done. For he is worthy of everything, and we worship him and glorify our God. In Jesus' name. Amen.
All the saints and angels bow before your throne. All the elders cast their crowns before the Lamb of God and sing. All the saints and angels bow before your throne. All the elders cast their crowns before from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. You are worthy of it all.
So worthy.
You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things. To you are all things. You deserve the glory. worthy is the Lamb. You are holy. All the saints and angels bow before your throne. All the elders cast their crowns before the Lamb of God and sing, you are worthy of it all. You are worthy. From you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory.
You're worthy of it all.
You are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all. Glory.
We'll sing verse one again.
All the saints and angels bow before your throne. All the elders cast their crowns before the
Just hold that thought in your hearts about how Jesus was like the Lamb for you and stood in that place. I'm glad Ron jumped in with that. But yeah, this is a song of like elders like praising constantly in heaven forever because Jesus is worth it. He's always been there and he always will be there.
And we have nothing to bring him except ourselves and come back into that perfect creation position in Christ. We don't look at our own merits or our own strengths. We just say,
my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but only trust in Jesus' name.
My hope
is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, trust in Jesus' name.
Let's sing Christ alone.
Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of. Hide his face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In every house stormy gale. My anchor holds within the veil. My anchor holds within the veil. Oh, Christ the Lord, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord on all. When He shall come with trumpet sound, oh, may I then in Him be found, dressed in His righteousness alone. Faultless I stand before the throne.
Christ alone,
Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the Savior's love, through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of all.
Amen.
Yeah, please take your seats. Thank you very much, band. Today, brilliant. It's all just really gave me this sense of just being together in community, and that's what church is. If you've never heard this word church before, it's all about this community and being together, a community that is centered around Jesus. I was 26 and I'd never been to a church service. I'd done 14 years in the Air Force, so I'd been to a remembrance service at like a really posh like Anglican church before, but I'd never been in knowingly in 26, and the woman I was with at the time, she wanted us to go to church, and I thought, fine, we'll go. She'll stop moaning at me and nothing will happen and she'll leave me alone. But we went, and when we were there, I heard this thing said to me, I'd never heard it before. And I heard that God created the world and it was perfect. But we, with our own choices, have broken that perfect creation. And I'm sure every single person here can think of a way that they've lived a life and it's not been the perfect way that God would have us live. But I heard that God Himself came and hung on a cross and died. So that all the debts that I owed to God for breaking that perfect creation, God had died to pay those debts. And I could be forgiven of all that I had done in my life. And I had done a lot wrong, brothers and sisters. But I could be forgiven of it all if I recognized that death of Jesus as my own and gave my life over to Him. But not only that, God would create a new creation where it's all joy, where He rules on His throne, where it's all peace, it's all love, and I could be part of that new creation that is to come. And I heard God speak to me, and I gave my life over to Jesus, and He changed my life, and I lived completely differently from that moment on. And at that moment, when I gave my life to Jesus, I was welcomed into church, this community together, where we joy in and we celebrate the God who has died for us and the new life that He has called us to. And it's been amazing over this past few years to see the journey that God's been taking this community together on, particularly at the moment over this last year, the work He's been doing in our younger people as well. And it's just been an amazing year. Last time we had this baptistry open, we ran out of time for the rest of the service because so many of our young people gave their life to Jesus and wanted to come through these waters of baptism. And we've got another baptism service on the 8th of September. And if you're at that place where you have given your life over to Jesus, and today could be that day where you do that, our brother Elorm's going to preach later, and he's going to tell you about our Lord, Savior, Jesus Christ. And if you decide that today's the day that you want to give your life over to Jesus, or if it happened years ago, but you've never been through those waters of baptism, well, the 8th of September, here they are. This will be filled up. It's nice and warm. It's about 36 degrees. It's lovely. And the change that you've made in your heart, this is the physical sign of that change that you made in your heart. You go into the water, you're laid to death, you're washed fresh, and then you're birthed to new life, a new creation, a new person, blessed and called by Jesus to live a life for him. But he's been doing an amazing work with our young people over this summer, and Sue is going to come and share about some of that amazing work that Jesus has been doing.
Okay, so I don't know if you all remember, but in August, we took some of the youth, the older youth, on Limitless, which was from the 3rd to the 8th of August, and we just have a video that we're going to show right now. It was very exciting. Okay. It's coming. I've got all the youth at the top waiting.
I'm living in the light of a new day. I won't waste another minute in my old ways. Praise the Lord, I've been born again. Goodbye yesterday. I'm living in the light of a new day. I won't waste another minute in my old ways. Praise the Lord, I've been born again. Yeah.
Good. It really was that fantastic, actually. It was as good as the video showed. I also want to really thank the Sugdens, who did amazing food, as you could see on that video. They did amazing food. And I also want to thank all the other helpers. You know who you are. I want to thank all the other helpers as well. So if your young person is in, or young people as well, if you are in year 8 of this year, so from in 2026 you'll be going to year 9, but if you're going into year 8 this current year that's about to start, then you can go to Limitless next year. You've saw the dates, it's from the 9th of August. If we book before the end of the week, we get an extra discount. I know that is really in advance, but if anyone, you can still book after that, but if you want the extra discount, then please contact me this week, parents, and let me know. But yeah, be definite that you can go, because the church have to pay in advance. So please let me know if you're definitely wanting to go next year. Maisie and Nathan, can I ask you to come down and just say a little bit about Limitless? And if Ollie, if you can come up in a minute about something else. Kamsi, if you want to come, you can, or you can stay there. So just a few of them that went have just come forward just to say what Limitless was like for them and how God spoke to them as well. So Maisie, you can go first if you want.
Okay, hello. So over at Limitless, we had a fantastic time. To be honest, for our youth group, we haven't been that close, but during Limitless, I would say I've grown to know everyone much more, especially Kamsi with the second place in the volleyball tournament and his rants. They kept us entertained, definitely, I have to say. But probably the best bit about Limitless was the sessions every single day that we got, morning and evening. The worship was just incredible. I have no words to describe what it was like, just praising with everybody, no care for anybody thought. And then also we got a time to prayer every single day, which was just fantastic because I got to see God working through so many people. Through me, because one of my experiences was we were asked to lay hands on someone and just listen to what God had to say, and then tell the person what God had said to us about them. So if one of my friends, I didn't know really what was going on, but I laid my hands on her, and I just felt calm and peace, and just pictures of calm and peace were just washed over me. So I told her about that, and she was really grateful for that. But then I also grew in confidence, because for me, I'd never prayed out loud before, but that was a real good time for me to grow in confidence and learn to pray out loud. But yeah.
I mean, I enjoyed a lot of things about Limitless, but the one thing I did enjoy most were the sermons. They were talking about prayer all throughout the week. And personally, it did really help me, because I remember, hopefully not to embarrass Ollie, but when we were praying, like, and we were putting our hands on each other, seeing what God said, he said, continue how you are going, but develop prayer. And I was thinking, well, I think that's correct for me. But yeah, it's just really helped me connect with God, like, more with prayer and, like, how to talk to him, not just seeing him as some high guy in the sky, but, like, father, friend. Speaking to him, being with him. And yeah, I really enjoyed that.
Okay, so there was a lot of like really interesting stuff. For example, we did do a volleyball tournament. Unfortunately, we lost the final of that volleyball tournament. Yeah. Yeah, they were cheating. They were cheating. 100% they were cheating. But I've let that go, don't worry. But yeah, the sermons were amazing, though, to be honest. I think my favorite sermon was the one by Pastor Agu, who talked about prayer being communion with God, talking with God, the different types of prayer, how there's petition to God, but there's also intercession, which is praying for others. And the worship as well was phenomenal. The Sunday night, I think, there was African worship, and I don't think I saw anyone sit down, to be honest. I remember, huh? No. I was more of an observer of the African worship. I wasn't really much of a dancer, if you know what I mean. These 2 feet aren't for dancing, but yeah. We also got a lot closer as a youth group. We played a lot of card games together. When I say that these girls are so good at card games, it's no joke. They were like, what's the game called? Taco. The slapping the thing. They slap it so fast, it's so unnecessary. But yeah, I think Limitless helped us get a lot closer as a youth group and get us a lot closer to Christ. And to be honest, I cannot wait for next year.
Well, I have to say that Kamsi kept us all joyous all week. I have to say that. Mainly through his ranting. And there's just one more thing I want to do today. You know, we do have an amazing youth in this church, and it was such a privilege. And Maisie said something very key. The reason I took our youth on Limitless wasn't just so that they grew in Jesus, but actually that they formed those really good friendships. And it was delightful to see that happen throughout the week. There were some really good friendships that really grew throughout the week. By the end, they were all dancing in the field in the dark with the glow things on them. So they all got to know each other. But also, next year we have, Ollie, would you like to come up? We have two of our youth who are going to be head students at Katmos. And I just think that's amazing that two of our young people are going to be those head students. And what a privilege that is for them. Sorry, guys. I think that was an extra long applause then, guys. But also, it's a huge responsibility as well. And they're also doing GCSEs this year. So last week I said to Maisie, would you like us to pray for you? And she literally jumped at it. So I was hoping Ollie was okay about it as well. But I thought it would be really good for us to just pray for them this week. They start back on Thursday, I believe. So I thought it'd be really good for us to pray for them this week and just pray that God just really helps them throughout the year. And they stand out above any other head students because they know Jesus and Jesus is helping them. So can we just all, if you can all put your hands out, youth, put your hands out and pray too. But I'm just going to pray for them both. Lord, I just want to pray for Maisie and Ollie, Lord, and just the privilege they have of being head students this year. But Lord, we stand behind them in this, Lord, and we know you're standing behind them. And we just ask that you would just give them real wisdom and real integrity in their day-to-day life as they do these roles. That you will help them to just be able to make great decisions, Lord. And they will just shine above any other head student because they know you, Lord. That people will look back for many generations and say, they were just really great. And Lord, I just pray that you will be with them as they study for GCSEs as well this year and all the other things that they've got to do, that you will give them the strength and ability to do everything they need to do each and every day. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask for your anointing to be upon them in this role. In your name, amen. Amen. Right. So as you can see, it's very exciting. And I sent an email out this week that says all the other things. Can I just say for parents of youth, the film this week for film afternoon is going to be Inside Out 2, not 1, 2. I've managed to get 2. So that's quite a new film out. So if they want to come along, can you let me know by the end of tomorrow? That would be fantastic. Right, finally, kids. It's finally got to you, kids, and it's time to go out. Can we have it up on the screen? All the different age groups. There we go. So we have Adventure 0 to 4 years. We have Discover Years 1 and 2 and Explore Years 3 and 5. Discover and Explore are together today. So you're upstairs, both of you. You're both upstairs today. Adventure, you're in the back room. Can I just say, if you're new here, please let the helpers know. And can all parents take your children out as well? I'm just going to pray for those children. And can I also say, if there's any youth you're in today to listen to Elorm, if there's any year six that would like to go with Explore today, then you're welcome to go, but I just need their parents to take them. Okay. Lord, I just want to thank you for our amazing kids and youth in this church, that we are so privileged to have so many. And I just pray for our kids as they go out this morning, that you will bless them, that you will be with them as they learn about Job, that you will inspire them, Lord. And that you will just help everyone that's a helper in that as well, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I want to pray for our youth as they stay in and listen to Elorm, that you will inspire them from the words that are spoken, in your name. Amen.
He wanted to go out on that, but he wants to stay in. He said he can't wait to hear the Holy Spirit speak through Elorm, so he's going to stay in. Listen to that. Cool, so I've just got a couple of notices to let you know about. So, we're not here next week. Oh, but it's good. We're going to be meeting at Cuts Close in the park. So instead of being here next week, we've got a service outdoors. So Cuts Close is the park right in the middle of Oakham. Do use Google Maps, you can't miss it. It's right near the big pointy Anglican church. It's the central part there. So we're going to have a service from 11 o'clock. And then after the service, we're going to stay around. There's going to be music, bring a picnic with you. We're going to have kids, crafts and events. And there's going to be like a little cafe as well. So please do come along to that. Invite your neighbours to it. If you follow the church on Facebook, on Instagram, make sure you share those posts as well so people can see that it's on. So that's next week. So there'll be no 1:30 service and no 6 p.m. service next week either. So it's just in the park at 11 o'clock. So please do come along to that. The week after is the 8th. We've got baptisms as well. If you want to be baptised, then come and speak to me at any point through the week, and I'll be able to explore a little bit more with you about baptism. And so the 1:30 service today, we're going to be exploring the question, what does the Bible say about human sexuality? So that's going to be at 1:30, so do stay around for that. Go get lunch, come back, and stay for that. That should be great. And this morning, we're looking at the question, what is the Bible? And Elorm is going to come and share that with us. So I'm going to ask you to come up, brother, and I'm going to pray for you. Lord, I want to thank you for this mighty man of God. First, I want to thank you, Lord, for the foundation of faith that Carmelita and Lenny have put in his life and the life of Leonda as well. I want to thank you that they've seen you at work, Lord Jesus, and they've tasted and seen that you are good. And I want to thank you that the way Elorm has walked fully in faith into the life that you've called him to. I want to thank you for the witness he is to his peer group around him and to all people as well. The way that he has seen you move, Holy Spirit, in amazing ways in his life. I want to thank you for the word that you've put on his heart over these past few weeks and months he's been preparing for today. And as he speaks today, may it be not his words, but your words, Lord Jesus, that come from his mouth. Fill him with confidence. Fill him with your presence. May he know that he is the man who you call to stand here at this very time. May he speak with courage. May he speak with clarity. And may your Holy Spirit reveal your truth and wisdom to all of us through him today. Be with him, Lord, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. So if you've got a Bible, if you want to grab it, if you've not got a Bible, then if you stick your hand up, oh, look at Jen, that's perfectly timing. You have to give them all out now. Jen, oh, it's like a married thing. Oh, Zach. It's like a husband and wife team. They will give you Bibles. If you stick your hand up, if you've got your own Bible, do great. If you don't own a Bible, then do take one of those Bibles with you. That is yours to keep. If you're more of a phone person, there are some great Bible apps that you can use as well. Elam, it's all yours, brother.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't a bit nervous. As you said, my name's Elorm. And today, I'm going to be trying to answer what is the Bible. So, where do you guys turn when trouble strikes? Oftentimes, a lot of people turn to the wrong things, or sometimes they may not even know where they're turning, and they feel hopeless and lost. Well, hopefully, today, I'm able to help you realize that. So, where I would advise you firstly to turn is the Word of God, obviously. Because the Bible is more than just a book, okay? It is the unfolding revelation of the Almighty God, okay? And the Bible is also a promise book. But unlike all promises, the promiser has infinite power and he sticks to his word all the time. As you look through scripture, God is always helping those. God is always helping his people and working in the lives of his people. And so the Bible is more than just a book, okay? Now, what is the purpose of the Bible? The first purpose I'm going to talk about is to reveal the one true God, okay? There will be many that come and say they are God, or there will be many that come and say they follow a different God. But in Matthew, and it says this in Matthew 24:5, where it says, "For many will come in my name, claiming I am the Messiah, and they will deceive many." But the Bible's purpose is to reveal the one true God. It's to paint a clear picture of the one true God. Now, the question I'd ask you guys is, if we didn't have the Bible, how would you describe God? How would you know God? You wouldn't be able to. I think you'd have a very worldly perspective of how God is, and that is why the Bible is so important, because it reveals to us God's character, and it reveals to us who he is. The second purpose I want to talk about is the Bible being more... Oh, sorry. The second purpose I want to talk about is the Bible leading us to salvation. the Bible. We need to realize that we are all sinners, okay? And it's sometimes harder for us to realize this more than others, but we are all sinners, and by God's grace, we have all been saved. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that so whoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. So we need to realize this. And he has forgiven us all of our sins by being the sacrificial lamb. Now, the third point I want to talk about on the purpose of the Bible is how to live a godly life, okay? Now, what is a godly life? A godly life is a holy life, a life that represents God and his character and how we are supposed to live. And personally, because obviously I'm only 18, so as a teenager, I see a lot of, especially in today's youth, I can say a lot of our youth are quite wild, and it's hard to live a godly lifestyle, especially in this generation, because there are so many influences, social media, parties, drinks, drugs, everything. But we need to remind ourselves that God has given us this book to know how to live a godly lifestyle. And a lifestyle like this is filled with obedience. So we need to have obedience in God. And obedience is filled with immediate repentance. So we need to realize our faults and we need to realize our wrongs and we need to repent every single day. Okay. The next purpose I'm going to talk about is serving God. How we serve God and share the message with others. As I'm doing here today, hopefully I do inspire some of the youth or everyone around that God can work through us all. God can work through us all, and God can work in so many different ways. God can share the message through so many different ways. Okay, now I'm going to talk about how the Bible, I'm going to sum up. Can everyone in their Bibles turn to Psalm 119, 105, if you can? Just pour myself some water in. I'll just give you guys a few more seconds. Yep, I think everyone's ready. So, obviously, this verse says that God is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. And I think that sums up the Bible perfectly. In my opinion, that God is the light in this darkened world, and this world is very dark as it is corrupted by sin, but God is the light for us to look at and know where to go by following him. And the Bible also says, the grass withers, the flowers fade, but the word of our God stands forever, and that is because the truth of God's word is timeless. Secondly, the word of God is infallible as well. And thirdly, the word of God is the truth, because God is the way, the truth, and the life. Now, we're going to talk about the consequence of disobedience. So, obviously, as we've all lived our lives, we all come to God from different places, and we all have to respect that God has set rules for us in place, for example, the Ten Commandments. And the consequence of disobedience is obviously sin, because so our lifestyles need to reflect God, because if we don't, we're in serious trouble, because God has set a life for us to live by, and oftentimes a lot of people want to pick and choose how they live, what verses they want to live by. Oh, this looks nice in the Bible, oh, but this doesn't look nice, so I don't want to follow it. We have to stick to God's word. It's you either live by the lifestyle or you don't live by the lifestyle that God has set for you. And there are going to be consequences regardless of whether we want there to be consequences or not. So we have to live in obedience. We have to keep to his word. But we need to remind ourselves that God has an unconditional love for all of us, okay? God's love, again, I say John 3:16 is such an important verse, because that is a perfect picture of God's love for us all. But thankfully as well, the Bible, again, as I said, it's more than just a book. The Bible provides a way for us. It shows us how we can be saved. It says, for by grace are ye saved through faith, not of yourselves, not of works, lest than any man should boast. So we know, again I say, by grace. We are not, it is not by our works, but by God's grace. And God did not have to give up his life for us. God did not have to do that, but he did. And that is showing God's unconditional love for us. And he came down and died for our sins. And he didn't just come, for an example, but to save us for save us from our sin. Now, I'm going to talk about the resurrection. So, well, firstly, you may be asking, what do I need to be saved from? Again, I say sin, because sin is a destroyer. Sin destroys everything that is good and right. But God has come and made a way for all of us and forgiven us of our sin. That's why Paul says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, believe in your heart, God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. So we have to believe in our hearts. And personally, it can be hard for me at times, because there are times where I do doubt, and we all doubt, and I know everyone doubts. But we just have to remain in faith. We have to remain knowing in our hearts, regardless of the situation that we are in, that God is for us. And if God is for us, who can be against us? Jesus is Lord. Believe him to be God in your heart, and you will be saved. Now, when Jesus left us with the Holy Spirit, which is the Holy Spirit is there to empower us and impact our beliefs and our lives, okay? So sometimes when you feel like you can't do it alone, you know that God is with you through the Holy Spirit, and you have to allow the Holy Spirit to guide you when you feel lost. Now, Jesus was born of Virgin Mary, okay? Now, he was born of Virgin Mary because the Lamb of God had to be the perfect Lamb. Throughout Scripture, we have seen that sacrifices, they usually have to be perfect. No sick lambs, no blemishes, they have to be perfect. And that is why Jesus was perfect. Jesus was perfect. He was born to be perfect and sinless. And he died on the cross for us. He bore our sin, he bore your sin and my sin on the body of the tree. Now, this is again a reflection of God's unfolding love and God's perfect love. And we find all of this in the Word. That is why the Bible, again, I say, the Bible is so important for us to read. We will not have this connection with God if we do not read his Word. In John 1:1, it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So in order for us to understand God and know God and know his Word, we have to read the Word more and more. And this has to be a daily activity. This has to be a daily activity, because if we're not in God's Word, we won't hear from God. Also, with knowing that Jesus came down and died for us and he sealed our fate with his grace, we don't need to fear death because we have God. The Bible tells us, it says, absent from the body and present with the Lord. What does the lost person say? What do you think is going to happen when you die? Anyone? Tom? What do you think is going to happen? Amen. Anyone else? What do you think?
Face-to-face.
Amen. Amen. And that is the truth. We do not have to fear death, because we know that if we trust in our Lord and Savior, we will spend eternity with him. But that only comes by his grace and our faith, not by our works. Now, if anyone hasn't recognized Jesus in their life, hopefully today, after this, I pray that you come to realize how good a God we serve, how good God is, because he has died on the cross. He has bore your sin and mine. We just have to put our trust in him. And by reading the Bible, we truly understand this. Okay. Now, may everyone close your eyes while I end in prayer. Dear Father God, I want to thank you for allowing me to spread your word today. Lord, I want to thank you for working through me to the lives of those who may need you, Lord, and to the lives of those who may think they may not need you, Lord, but they do. Lord, I pray that as we go throughout this life, Lord, I pray that you guide us through the Holy Spirit. Lord, I pray that you guide us through your word, Lord, and I pray that you continue to just be the amazing God you are. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. That's it.
Lord, that's amazing, mate. It's great to know the word that God's put. We're looking for you then. We're wondering where you've gone. You're walking up the stairs. Mate, that was amazing. Well done. It's brilliant. See, the word that God put on your heart and that you faithfully came and shared with us today. Just absolutely amazing, brother, and bless you for that. And thank you so much. So whilst you've got your Bibles on, you just want to open them up to a letter that Paul wrote called 2 Timothy. So it's in the New Testament. You've got the Gospels, and then you've got the... you've got Acts, which is like Luke part 2, and then you've got the letters that Paul wrote to the church. And the last ones of his letters are the what we call the pastoral epistles. So Paul's writing to a guy called Timothy and also a guy called Titus, and he's telling them about how they can live the Christian life and how they can nurture the churches that they're called to live in and to love. So if you turn to 2 Timothy, feel free to use the index at the front of your Bible. And if you flick to that, we're looking at 2 Timothy 3, verse 16. So 2 Timothy 3, verse 16, it says this. Paul's writing to this church leader, and he says, "All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work." Useful for teaching. We're happy with that, right? It's useful for teaching. We like things that teach us. We want to grow. We want to grow and we want to learn. We'll watch help videos online and stuff like that. Teaching's good. Rebuking. Not so. Who likes a bit of a rebuke? Who's married? Yeah, I guess a lot, right? Yeah, we're used to a bit of rebuking. But it's this idea of rebuking. It's when you've done something wrong, pushing you back into the place where you're living the right life. Again, like Elorm shared, it's this, the word of God is a light to my feet and it guides your path. Keeping this idea of when you go astray, the word of God brings you back onto the place that you need to be. Correcting. Showing you the way that you should live, a life that you should do. The Bible is this guiding influence on us and training in righteousness, helping us live the lives that God is calling us to. And that's what the Word of God is. I was, when Elorm and I were meeting yesterday to talk about today, and we were on about what is the Bible and how great it is, and said, just imagine that if somebody has suddenly discovered a book that was over 4,000 years old, and in there, it talked about God who created the universe and then also gave people a way that they should live. Could you imagine? It'd be everywhere. It'd be all over the news, wouldn't it? Check out this amazing ancient script. And here we have it. And how often do we take it for granted? If you were suddenly given this and you didn't know it was there before, and you know, I became a Christian at 26, didn't know what the Bible was, I had no sort of idea of what it was. I just thought it was a book of like songs and stuff like that. I thought it had hymns in and stuff like that. And when I learned that this was so ancient, so old, and full of the wisdom of the creator of the universe, I couldn't put it down. I read my Bible front to back in about 2 months, just all the way through. I just couldn't. All I wanted to do was just find out about this God who suddenly revealed his truth to me, this loving Father who revealed his truth to me. And praise the Lord that I've been able to read my Bible daily, every single day since. And like Elorm said there, it's a book to be read daily. It's how we hear from God. It's how God communicates to us. I want to encourage you, brothers and sisters, that if you aren't every single day in the Word of God, I want you to start. It is the main way that you will grow in faith. It is the main way that you will hear and learn from God. What is it, Elorm, your TikTok? A Bible verse a day keeps the devil away? Is that right? It's true. It's true. But I want to encourage you, more than just a verse, I want you to saturate yourself in the Word of God. I want you to read through whole books at a time. Get the entire context. If you don't do it, if there's one thing that you leave today doing, it's reading your Bible every single day. Being in the presence of God's word and hearing from what God wants to say to you. So that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every single good work. The good works that God is calling you to. to reconcile Rutland to the kingdom of God, to change this community around us into a place of love, into a place of hope, into a place that is where people are no longer given over to their individualistic ambitions, but they are given over to acts of service to create the kingdom of God here on earth. Elorm, thank you for your message today. Absolutely amazing, brother. And please do afterwards, if God speaks to you through Elorm's message today, do let him know about what the Holy Spirit has said to you. I'm going to invite the worship team to come up, and if you'll join me in prayer, and then we'll get into a time of praise and worship together. Lord Father, I want to thank you for your holy word. I want to thank you that we don't have to guess how to follow you. It's here. There's enough mystery in these pages where we can never know you fully and completely until that day, like Mavis says, when we see you face to face, Lord Jesus. But until that day, may you guide us, may you lead us. May we treat your word with the authority and the reverence it needs, because these are your words given to us. And may we ever increasingly be given to teaching, being rebuked, to being corrected and being trained in righteousness, so that we, your servants, may be thoroughly equipped for every single good work. Amen. If you're able, let's stand and let's praise together.
These scriptures say that they are for the servant of God, and it's for those who know Christ, who have entered into that relationship again. And it says, scripture is God breathes for you. For you to get better at serving. So, if that is you today, then you can sing this.
Lord, you have my heart, and I will search for yours. Jesus, take my life and lead me on. Lord, you have my heart, and I will search for yours. Jesus, take my life and lead me on. Lord, you have my heart, and I will search for yours. To you a sacrifice, and I will praise you, Lord. I will praise you, and I will sing of love come down. I will sing of love come down as you show.
Sing of love come down.
do interact with the scriptures under the Holy Spirit. He has a way of undoing us and then putting us back together more like Jesus.
You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies till all my fears are gone. I'm no longer a slave.
For us. He unravels us and puts us back together that we might be servants of the Most High God in a fallen world. No wonder we can bless God. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship Your holy name.
The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning,
it's time to sing Your song. Time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 reasons and forevermore,
forevermore.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy.
Suzanne spoke about You calling us, and we thank You for that call. Today, if you hear His voice, answer in faith and say yes. It is the strongest message you can send to the world, to Satan, and to everyone around you. Lord, today we say yes to whatever ministry, mission, or task you set us to do. In Jesus' name.
Than the mountains that I face, stronger than the power of the grave, constant in the trial and the change. One thing remains.
So do that one again.
One thing remains. Runs out on me. Your love never fails, it never gives up, it never runs out on me. Your love never fails, it never gives up, it never runs out on me. Your runs out on me. Your love
in death,
in death, in life, I'm confident and covered by the power of your great love. My debt is paid, there's nothing that can separate my heart. Fails, it never gives up, it never runs out on me. Your love never fails, it never gives up, it never runs out on me. Your love.
We're going back to verse one. Higher than the mountains,
higher than the mountains that I face, stronger than the power of the grave.
trial and the change, one thing remains, one thing remains.
The love of God, and we give our praise. May the Lord Almighty bless us and remind us of encounters with him that change us from sinners to saints, from the subservient to servants of the living God, from those who are trodden down to those who are raised up in Christ. Lord, may your blessing be in us and on us, that we might be servants of the living God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
So do stay around. There's tea and coffee served through there. Enjoy the time, the conversation together. And remember, the 1:30 service, we're looking at what does the Bible say about human sexuality. There's no 6 p.m. service tonight. And next week, 11 o'clock at Cuts Close. So, Lord Father, bless us this week on the journeys that you've called us to. May we serve you in all the ways and the different types of places you've called us to serve. At school, at college, at work, in our families, with our friends and neighbours. And, Father, may your glory go before us, behind us, and surround us this week, we pray. In your name, Lord Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen.